Hello learners, welcome to NIOS Studio. I'm Dr. Suparna Jain from Daulat Ram College, University of Delhi. And I'll be talking about lesson 9, that is stages of child development. That is for 3 to 6 year old children and 6 to 8 year old children. And in this particular video, I'll be talking about cognitive development as an important domain for these children, these two age brackets. And once you thoroughly go through this video, you'll be able to describe the patterns of cognitive development among 3 to 6 year old children and 6 to 8 year old children. So this is the learning outcome from this video. So we must have heard about Jean Piaget, who is a very well known cognitive developmental psychologist, and he has given us 4 stages of cognitive development. Now these 4 stages of cognitive development, as you can see here on the flow chart that I have presented you, the first stage is sensory motor stage that pertains to 0 to 2 years of age. Then comes in pre-operational stage, that is for 2 to 7 year old children. Then concrete operation for 7 to 11 year old children. And then formal operational stage, that is for 11 and above. But because we are focusing on children starting from the age group of 3 and we are going on to 6, 3 to 6 and then 6 to 8. So let's focus on the pre-operational stage first. Now at this stage what happens is that the complexity of children's thought increase considerably, but at the same time they're still thinking illogically, their thinking is rigid, a little unsystematic, but they're still developing cognitively, and there are certain cognitive abilities that are helping them. So the first cognitive ability that they're gaining at this time is called symbolic function. Now what is symbolic function? That means they're able to now think in terms of images and symbols. So you must have seen at some time in life that you must have seen that there are children who, even in the absence of somebody physically present, they talk over the phone, they mimic what their parents do, they talk over the phone with somebody who's imaginary. So what is happening here? They're indulging into symbolic play. That is, they are now thinking in terms of images and symbols. They are able to use words and numbers to talk about objects which might not be present at the moment. So this is the first cognitive development for them. Second cognitive development is spatial thinking. Now what is spatial thinking? That is to be able to think in three-dimensional view of the world. At this time, they start gaining or attaining that ability of spatial thinking. Now, for example, if you present them with a photograph, so they understand that whatever is there in the photograph, it is not present around them at the moment, but it is something that exists. So this is a cue that they are growing in their spatial abilities. The third cognitive ability is causality. Now is the time that they understand that there are causes behind familiar events. So they are understanding the cause and effect relationship between things. One of the major and the simplest example here is that at this age, the age of 3 to 6, at this age they start understanding that every living thing will grow when the living thing will get nutrition. When they receive nutrition, there will be a growth. So there is a cause and effect relationship that they understand. Plus now, they are able to link two events together, but sometimes they do make mistake. Now, what kind of mistake they make? Sometimes what happens is that they link two events which happen quite close in time and space. For example, if they have a negative thought and immediately after that their sibling falls sick. So what happens is they start associating these two things together, and they start feeling that because they had the negative thought, this is what that led to the ill health of the sibling. Now what is happening here? They are interpreting a cause and effect which is incorrect. So still they are not able to reason logically, but they are striving hard. Now the fourth cognitive ability that they are gaining is categorization and identities. Categorization is that when they are able to categorize objects around them based on the similarities and differences in those objects. So for instance, now they are able to categorize objects as good or bad, edible, inedible, friendly, non-friendly, utensils, furniture, and so on. So now they know that these kind of objects can be, you know, categorized together as similar. So this is what they are learning. Now there is something very interesting that was brought up by Piaget under categorization and identities, that is called animism. He said that at this stage, children, what they do is they attribute lifelike characteristics to the non-living objects. You must have observed little girls of this age, they feed their dolls, they dress their dolls, they give them a bath. So what is happening here? They start believing or they start assuming that even a non-living thing has life. And this is actually helping them in developing cognitively because they're practicing their cognitive skills on a non-living thing. Okay, moving on to identities. They are still striving to understand identities because for them, the objects do remain same even when there is a change in their physical appearance in terms of forms and size. But very importantly, they still lack the ability to conserve. Now, what is conservation? Conservation is a very important concept given by Piaget. According to him, conservation is a logical thinking ability that allows a person to determine that a certain quantity will remain the same despite adjustment to shape or size. Let me give you an example of this. He did multiple experiments with the children to understand conservation. So I'll be replicating that experiment for you over here. What he did was he took coins. So I've also taken 2 rupees coins here. So here what I have done is I have made two rows. This is row one where there are 6 2 rupees coins and all of them have been placed tightly together. And here in the second row again I have 6 coins of 2 rupees and all of them have been placed farther apart from each other. Now if I ask a 3 to 6 year old child who is still in the pre-operational stage of cognitive development according to Piaget, here when I ask the child that which of the rows has more coins, then most of the children in this stage, in the pre-operational stage, they would make a mistake by saying that this row has, that is row 2 has more coins as compared to row 1. Why? Because they have been spread apart. So because they look more, because they are more, they're taking more space on the table, so these children believe that they are also more in number as compared to the ones in row 1. So what I'm trying to say over here is that for the pre-operational stage children, the thinking is not as well developed, especially the logical thinking, that they are able to not be clear about the concept of conservation, wherein they understand that both the rows have equal number of coins. But as the children move to the age group of 6 to 8, here what happens is because they've moved to the concrete operational stage, their logical thinking has developed and they will not make an error here or have a confusion about the number of coins in the two rows. They would rather say that there are equal number of coins in both the rows. So this is the concept of conservation which still has to be achieved by the 3 to 6 year old bracket of children. Now the fifth cognitive ability is egocentrism, which is very interesting because what is happening over here in egocentrism is that children are not able to distinguish between their own perspective and the perspective of the other person. So they do not understand that there are different viewpoints that exist. So the thinking, their cognitive ability is still developing, as a result of which there comes in egocentrism. So they have to overcome this aspect of thinking in a very skewed manner, wherein they are only believing that whatever they think, whatever they perceive is the correct perception. So let me give you a very common example. So for example, if a child likes a particular of this age, child of this age, if that child likes a particular cartoon character, he or she would also believe that the entire world likes that cartoon character because it is something that is likable, right? Okay, Piaget also did another experiment to explain this egocentrism in these children of this particular age. This experiment is called the Three Mountain Problem. In this Three Mountain Problem, he created a model of mountains or a scenery wherein there were three mountains and when the child was placed in four directions. So for example, this is the model here and the child is placed in this, this, this and this direction. That is all the four directions pertaining to the model. So the child was asked that what is the child seeing from a particular direction. So for example, what Piaget did was that when the child looks at the model from this particular direction, there is a tiger that he can see along with the mountains, of course. When the child is sitting here, there is a hut that the child can see, okay, and so on. So when the child was shown from all the four perspectives what the model looks like. Then later the child was asked that, for instance, if the child is sitting here on my left and there's a doll that is placed on the right, so the child would be asked that what is that that the doll is now seeing in the model. So for example, if there is a hut over here and the doll, in the doll's view, there is a hut along with the mountains, the child will still not say that there is a hut here, because the child believes what he is seeing in the model is the correct view, is the only view that exists in the world. So he, if he's seeing a tree here with the mountains, he would believe that even the doll can see the tree with the mountains, and that is it. So this is an example of egocentrism that prevails during this particular age group, because the children are still developing cognitively. Moving again to the stages of cognitive development given by Piaget. Now, as we proceed to the age bracket of 6 to 8 year old, they somehow fall in the concrete operational stage. And here in the concrete operational stage, children have developed cognitively as compared to when they were in the pre-operational stage. So now children are able to think more logically, their thinking becomes more flexible, but they're still thinking in concrete situations. They're still, you know, have not mastered the abstract thought. But now they're able to remember the routes to their familiar destinations like home, school, and places like that. And now, interestingly, they're able to conserve number, length, liquid. So the example of the experiment that I just showed you with the coins, the children of concrete operational stage, as I stated earlier also, they will be able to give me a correct answer because their logical thinking has improved. Also, they become zero in egocentrism, so they improve in egocentrism and they understand that people have differing viewpoints. Along with this, there are other cognitive abilities that they develop. Now, these children of the age bracket 6 to 8 are able to describe experiences that they have had. They become more selective in their attention, and even their attention span increases. Plus, now when they ask you a lot of questions, those questions are based on observation that they do. And also, they acquire a lot of information at this stage through media. So you can see how important it is to provide stimulation to children of this particular age groups from 3 to 8 year olds, because this is the time that they are developing cognitively, majorly they are developing cognitively. So it's very important to provide them with all of the opportunities so that they can achieve the heights in cognitive development. Thank you.